Happy Mardi Gras! Cindy Sparling here. It is the day before Fat Tuesday, so I thought I'd have a little fun with you guys showing you how to make a homemade king cake. What a fun project for you or your family, or to treat your friends, or to take to a get-together you might have tomorrow. You know, the king cake is a tradition of the Mardi Gras season, and it's especially a power food for the day of Fat Tuesday. And when I say power food, I mean loaded with sugar. You know, one of the traditions of Fat Tuesday, one of the eating traditions at least, is a sweet donut-type pastry. And that's how the king cake was formed. So I thought we'll have a little fun with this because I'm going to show you our version of a king cake, which is so quick and easy to make. So I'm going to be baking this today on our large white round stone, and I've just started with 2 cans of refrigerated crescent rolls. You know what I'm talking about, the kind that come in a little can, and I am using the low-fat version. They'll cook up just fine if you want to use those. So what we want to do, make sure you keep those crescent rolls in your refrigerator and chilled until you're ready to work with them, because we want to easily be able to separate the little triangles. And if you let it sit out and get warm and gooey, it's going to be hard to separate them. So we're literally going to just lay these triangles out on our stone with the wide parts of the triangle overlapping and the points hanging off the edge of the baking stone. And then we're going to mix up a fun little filling. In our batter bowl, I have got an 8-ounce cream cheese that's been softened to room temperature. I've just kind of mixed that up a little bit. And we're going to add a few fun ingredients. We're going to add some brown sugar. So I thought it would be fun to measure that with our measure all cup so that you could see my little tip on how to measure brown sugar. So if you'll buy your brown sugar in one of these bags and set your cup where you want it, and we want, how much do we want? A half a cup. So we're going to set this right there on a half a cup. I don't know if you guys can see that in the video. And we're going to take it, we're going to go right down inside our bag and just squish it in there. And we are going to lift out, hopefully, a half a cup. Oops, no, we're not going to lift out. My brown sugar was a little hard. Let's see what I can do here. I'm getting caught on my bag. We're going to, well, we're not wanting to do this right, but we're going to try. It's nothing like being live here. Here we go. Success. Yay. So we're going to lift out 1/2 cup of firmly packed brown sugar. And the cool thing about doing it that way, and if your sugar is fresher than mine, you won't have to do what I just had to do. We're going to just boop, pop it right into our batter bowl. So no sugar crumbles all over your countertop from having to try to pour your sugar from the bag or box into a measure. And we're going to add about a teaspoon, I believe, of vanilla in here. Whoops, there went my lid. Oh, 1/2 teaspoon, I think. Want a little bit of vanilla in there, and we're going to save some to do in a little while. I just put all of it in there. It'll be good. And we're going to add a little bit of raisins. Here they are. Now, the raisins are optional, so if you're not a raisin fan, you could certainly leave those out. My bag is, there it is, it is open. So we're just going to pour in maybe a 1/4 cup of the little raisins in there. And we're going to stir all this together, and we're going to lay it out on our crescent rolls here. And give it a quick little stir. Oh, that's looking good. And then we're just going to go around, and we're going to spread this out on the wide bases of the triangles. Does that make sense? I'll hold this up so everybody can see in just a minute. So we get all the way around with our filling. You obviously do not want to take it all the way out to the edges because we're going to wrap this up. Now, if I were not doing this for Mardi Gras and Fat Tuesday, if you just wanted to do this as a morning, like Danish, you could add apples to it or anything else you want to do to make it a little more fun. But I want this to be more like a traditional king cake. So I've got my filling on there. We've gone all around, and I love these little scrapers because it just gets it all out of there. Put a little more right there. Set that aside. So this is what we have, and you don't need to fuss over it and try to make it too perfect because it's all going to be fine when it cooks up. And then we're just going to sprinkle our pecans around the ring, and it calls for about 1/2 cup of pecans. And to put this together, we're simply going to pick up our end pieces, we're going to pull them over, and we're going to tuck them in the center. And we're just going to go all the way around, And you're going to have little open slots. It's supposed to be that way. It'll poof up and be beautiful when it cooks. As a matter of fact, we'll put this in the oven and we'll cook it. And after it has a chance to cool, I'll go back and decorate it. So what we're going to do to decorate our king cake after it cooks and cools, we're going to make a little icing out of powdered sugar, milk, and vanilla, and we'll pour the glaze over the cooked king cake. And then we're going to sprinkle it with our different colors. We're going to sprinkle it with sugar, gold, green, and purple. Don't you love my collection of sugars here? But those are the Mardi Gras colors. So does everybody get the gist of how you put this together? And I'm going to go back and tell you a little bit more about the history of Mardi Gras. One second here. So we're just going to very quickly, you can throw this together faster than you can drive this to the store and spend 10 times as much buying one. So just throw it together. There it is. Doesn't have to be perfect because it's going to poof up and be beautiful when it cooks. And we'll take another picture of that. So that is all we're going to do other than bake it at this point. So let me tell you a little bit about the history or the tradition of the king cake. It began in France in the 19th century, honoring the Christian story of the three kings traveling with gifts for the Christ child. The cake's three colors, let's see which one's first. Purple stands for justice. Green, where'd it go? Green stands for faith. And gold stands for power. So those are the reasons you use these three particular colors, and you see them so much in your Mardi Gras beads, these colors. The cake's ring shape too is significant because it symbolizes the unity of all Christians, as well as the shape of a king's crown. Before plastic babies were available, bakers used to hide dried beans or peas or even coins inside of the cake. And what that represents is the people who find the piece that have the bean or the baby or whatever in it, are supposed to have good luck and riches for the next year. And they are named the king or queen of the Mardi Gras. So I do have some little babies. You can get those at Michael's or any of those kind of places that sell cake decorating supplies. So what I do is bake it first, let it cool, and then you can just lift up a little place in the bottom and stick the baby through there after it's had a chance to cool a little bit. We don't want to be melting any plastic babies in our king cake. And that way you can have the fun of somebody finding a piece that has the baby in it. So, here's to you. Happy Mardi Gras. Have fun. Join me on another video because I'll show you how to make jumping jambalaya. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.